spotted our first guest on America's Got Talent, where their dancing got them all the way to the finals.
They were here last season, and we're thrilled to have them back for an encore performance.
Please welcome All That Cloggers, Michael, Ethan, Brad, and Mark.
Yeah. Great job.
How y'all been? Good to see y'all. Good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you guys for coming back. An encore performance. Brilliant.
Great to see you.
Brilliant. Thank you for wearing white after Labor Day, by the way. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Now, y'all have been busy performing a lot since the last time we saw you guys.
We have. You know, November, December is pretty busy for us. It's our Christmas season. We do about 85 shows in those 2 months. At our home theater back in Myrtle Beach, we dance at the Carolina Opry Theater.
Yes.
We take a month off. Normally, but we actually went to Kentucky and did a big benefit concert for Bourbon County High School. Sorry, I'm trying to catch my breath.
No.
Why?
Can I get you water?
What'd you do?
No, we're good, we're good. So yeah, we did a big benefit concert there, raised a lot of money for the kids at the high school. Now we're back in Myrtle Beach preparing for the new season. There's a lot of new stuff that'll come in, a lot of old stuff that comes out so that the audience get a new, fresh show for the new year, so yeah.
Absolutely.
I'm sorry, I just have to just...
No, go ahead. Sorry.
We
I was
still
looking at it the whole time. It's amazing. That is unbelievable, man. That's a feat, and it didn't move while you were clogging.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, just to clarify, this is clogging, not tap dancing. There's a difference, right?
There is a big difference.
The biggest difference, I think, is to the music. Tap dancers will accent more of the melody of the music. Right. They'll dance to the melody of the music. We do, as you can see, more like the drum beat. Or that
the percussion, right.
That constant percussion. Okay. So in theory, a tap dancer would be dancing to what we're doing.
Nice.
And can mimic the melody. And then another big difference is the shoes.
Shoes are quite a bit different,
actually. Shoes are different.
Tap dancers have one solid tap on the toe and the heel. Cloggers have this, what's called a jingle tap.
Oh, okay.
The jingle tap.
It makes a lot more noise, but it forces you to be cleaner with your footwork or to get a little bit...
What is the hardest move to do in clogging?
Man, there's a lot of hard moves.
Like, what's one incredibly difficult move?
You know, there's one specific move, double doubles. Most cloggers know it.
Double doubles?
It's not necessarily hard, but when you see it as sitting in the audience point of view,
it always gets
it's really loud, it's really fast.
Sounds
so it looks really hard.
Yeah. What is a double double?
Double doubles, five. See?
Oh my gosh.
That's it, man. You can do that. You got it.
That was amazing. Four double doubles. That was
eight, 16
double doubles. That was crazy.
And that's primarily the standard double
doubles.
We do several different variations, harder variations of that.
Right.
What do you love most about what you do?
You know, I think the big thing for me, and I think all of us, we agree, it doesn't limit us in any way. We're allowed to put together any kind of choreography we want to any piece of music. You don't have to dance just to country, just to rock, just to rap, anything like that. You can put any kind of choreography, not limited at all. The big thing for us, as we've said 100 times, is the audience.
Right.
Yeah. Being able to dance in front of an audience, make them smile, get them into what you're doing.
Well, Well, I always love when people take a traditional art form and turn it a little more rock and roll, and you guys are definitely doing that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you guys very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.